Breaking bad habits is the cornerstone of self-improvement. But for most of us, it's incredibly difficult to do. I recently read The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg, and I'd like to share what I learned about the structure of habits, how to break bad habits, and how to stop them from coming back for good. There are three stages of a habit. The first is the cue, and this is the trigger, which could be a location, an emotional state, or someone else's actions. Next is the routine, which can be a mental or physical action that you take whenever presented with that specific cue. And lastly is a reward, and this is what you get from the habit that fulfills a craving in your brain. Here's an example of how this plays out. Let's say that every Monday around 10 a.m., there's a really stressful meeting and your alarm on your phone goes off about 5 minutes before to let you know. This is your cue. After the meeting is over, your routine is to go down to the break room and eat a cookie.
The time has come for this cookie!
The last stage of routine is the reward, which isn't the cookie itself, it's actually the satisfaction of a particular need. So it's really interesting to note that a habit is something that starts as a conscious and deliberate activity. But over time, our brain recognizes our particular routines and converts them into chunks of activity, largely for energy efficiency. As a routine becomes more and more automatic, the cue of your alarm going off for the stressful meeting actually creates an immediate craving, which ultimately drives a self-perpetuating habit loop. So how do you break a bad habit? Over the years, we've been told by experts that to break a bad habit, we need to fix the routine, like eating the cookie, to ultimately lose weight. But in fact, it's the cue and the reward in the habit loop that influence the habit itself. If you identify and focus on the cues and rewards, you can insert a new routine and eliminate the craving altogether. So if your routine is to go eat a cookie, Duhigg poses that you ask yourself a hypothetical question to identify the cue and the reward. Are you craving the cookie itself or a break from work? If it's the cookie, is it because you're hungry? In which case, an apple actually might work better. Or is it the burst of energy that the cookie provides? In which case, a cup of coffee might work just as well. This is going to take a little practice to become more mindful of your bad habits and determine which craving actually drives your routine. And it can be hard at first since these habits are almost completely automatic for you. Keeping a good habit. So if you've gotten as far as identifying the cues and rewards for some of your bad habits, you're often able to change the routine to something more positive or healthy, like swapping the cookie for an apple or drinking up a cup of coffee or something else. But in many cases, the bad habits decide to crawl their way back into the picture during inflection points, or in other words, moments of unexpected stress. There are two elements that tend to drastically improve people's ability to keep their new positive habits during these times. One is belief that change is possible, and two is a support system. Duhigg says that people must believe that change is possible. And for some, this is a belief in God, and others, it's merely believing in themselves. But most often, that belief only emerges with the help of a group. So if you've been struggling with replacing an unhealthy habit for a while and it hasn't worked, try to connect with someone or a group of people that can be supportive. All right, that's all I got for you. Thanks so much for watching. Hit that like button below if you like the video. Share the video with your friends. If you know anyone that is looking to fix a bad habit, I know we're coming up to 2017, a lot of New Year's resolutions happening, so we can try to work this habit loop into your 2017 routine and hopefully stop eating those cookies and maybe lose a little weight down the road. So thanks so much for watching.